Welcome all. In the last lecture, we have seen different classifications of the network. We have seen the active and passive network, then unilateral and bilateral network, lumped and distributed network, as well as linear and nonlinear network. Now, in active network, we have seen the network which are consisting of some active sources or voltage source or current source is called active network. So we will see today what are the energy sources, that is voltage sources and current sources, and what are different classifications of the energy sources. So first is energy sources. In these energy sources, we have voltage source, and current source. These two sources are there. Now, what is energy source? As I have told, there are basically two type of energy sources, voltage source and current source. So they, again, in this voltage source and current source, there may be two possibilities. One is they either may be ideal or practical case. So these two only, either it is having ideal as well as practical. So in ideal case voltage source is there, in practical case voltage source is there, or you can say ideal voltage source, practical voltage source, or ideal current source, practical current source. So we will see what are they. Now voltage source, ideal voltage source is defined as the energy source which gives constant voltage across the terminals, irrespective of the current drawn through the terminals. Say, this is a voltage source, and in the terminal, I have connected a load. Better I don't mention it as R, I am just mentioning it as a load. Say load. So the voltage across this, or the supplied voltage, does not depend on how much current it is drawing. Say, you know, if it is R, if this L means not inductance, I am just specifying it as load. Say the load is variable, means as you know resistance is constant, I am just considering this load is variable. It can change its resistance, impedance actually, just consider resistance, it can change the resistance. So instead of this, you will understand, say I have connected a potentiometer. Now I can change the wiper of the potentiometer. If I am changing this, the load value or the resistance value will change accordingly, this current will change. Okay, so they are telling that if the current drawn by the load is continuously changing, then also the terminal voltage will not differ. Say I am reducing the R, I will increase, and the combination will give you the same voltage drop. You are getting? And the symbol of the ideal voltage source, the symbol of the ideal voltage source is like this. Say it is V plus minus. Now this V, sometimes it is shown as VI. VI stands for input voltage, or it is shown by VS, source voltage. In this way we can define it. So it is symbol of the voltage source. So you can draw like this also, say VI, yes, in this way you can show it, or you can show it like VS, or you can show only by V. These are all notations followed by different literatures, means in different books different construction is there about this. So these are the symbol of a voltage source, and the graph of this may be shown like this. You see it is VL, means load voltage. You can show this voltage as VL, load voltage. So this is the y axis is load voltage, and x axis is say current, load current. Okay, so this is the VS or VI or V, whatever you can consider. So source voltage equal to constant. You see, even though the IL is changing, this source voltage is not increasing, not decreasing, it is constant. So VL, here VL equal to VI or VS, whatever you can consider. VI means input voltage. This voltage you can show like VI or VS, anything. You can write VS also, that is also that. So only one notation you have to follow, either V or VI or VS, whatever. V stands for voltage, input voltage. If you want to show it in terms of input voltage, you just mention it VI. If you want to mention it by source voltage, you just mention by VS, anything. So VL equal to VI, means this VL equal to VI, constant, it is not changing with time. This is the representation of ideal voltage source. This is voltage source but ideal. Now we will see this is the characteristics. Okay, now we will see the other part of the voltage source, that is practical voltage source. Now say we will draw a practical voltage source. Again it is VS, say plus minus. I am connecting a current limiting resistor, and I am drawing the load. So it is VL, you can say it is RL, load resistance. This R I am just considering as R1 or R2 or R3, whatever series resistance, whatever I have connected, or you can write it as RS also. This is the resistance of the source, internal resistance of the source. Now this voltage source is having some internal resistance, right? Here internal resistance, that internal resistance I have shown here, or you can consider it as series resistance, which is inherently there inside the voltage source. So I have just shown it by RS, in source resistance. Now you see practically every voltage source has some small internal resistance, this one RS, which is also shown in the figure, with voltage source, and is represented by, here it is represented by RS. Because of this series resistance RS, voltage across the terminal decreases slightly with increase in the current. It gives the expression, say what is the expression of this, VL equal to minus RSC into IL plus VS. You see, if you don't understand this step, just consider this voltage drop, this voltage, supply voltage will drop across this resistance and this resistance. So what is Vs? Vs equal to VL plus VRS. So voltage drop across RL and voltage drop across RS. Now we are interested to this VL. So what is VL? VL equal to minus VRS plus VS. That's what I have written here, directly written. If you want to write, this is equation number 2, this is equation number 1, 2, and this is 3. So it is clearly mentioned. Now you see, if RAC is there, due to this RAC, this IL will vary, isn't it? So it will drop linearly, practically it will drop slightly. So the expression will be like this. It must go in this way, but it will go slightly in this way. That's why after using some multiple use, the battery drained out, isn't it? So this is your ideal case, V ideal, and this is your V practical. V ideal we have just shown, na? And these are all same VL, voltage across load. This is IL, current through load, 0, and this is your voltage, this is your VS actually. V practical, VI. VI is not considered here, V practical is considered here. This is your VS equal to VL. In the previous case, VS was exactly equal to the VL. In this case, the VS is not equal to the VL. There is another term, VRS. This VRS is minus. So, minus RAC plus into IL. Due to this, in ideal case, is this VS is not equal to, exactly equal to IL. VP equal to V practical equal to VL. This is far lesser than the VS. Means whatever you are supplying, trying to supply in the load, you are not getting that due to this resistance RS. And if this RL is changing variable, on that case this VL will drop. Okay, so it is all about the practical voltage source. Thank you.